Good afternoon again. My name is Fernanda de la Fuente, and this time I am going to talk about my class number 2. This is from lesson plan 3. In every class, I am going to take a test about the vocabulary. We are working in this book. So in the lesson plan 3, the students must to give me the homework about these pages. And I am going to take a test about the vocabulary. Why? Because the students need to know more vocabulary to more easy the language to them. So after of the take a test, I am going to explain the topic of this class. So it is about the conditionals. We have many conditionals, which are zero conditional, first conditional, second conditional, and third conditional. What is the difference between the four of them? The difference between the four of them is that the zero conditional, we talk about things that are always or generally true. For example, if I wake up early, I don't miss the bus. So this is the way that you can confirm the zero conditionals. Why? Because the things is true. If is the conditional, if I wake up early, I don't miss the bus. So, this is the zero conditionals, and now I am going to explain the first conditional. The first conditional is the something that is possible either now or in the future. So, I am going to give you an example. If we go on a cruise, we will have a wonderful time. So this is possible. That's why is the first conditional. If we go on a cruise, is a possibility that it can success or not, and it can be in the future. What is the second conditional? The second conditional is when the thing is impossible or unlike in the present or in the future. So I am going to give you an example. If my mom won the lottery, she would buy a Mercedes. So that's why it can be an impossible thing. If my mom won, check the birth, the lottery, she could buy a Mercedes. It can be fast in the future. The third conditional is when the thing were possible but didn't happen. So I have an example. If I have known you didn't have a ticket, I would have given you one. That's why it can be possible, where possible. Always remember the conditional, we use the if, no? Yeah, in this moment, after of this explanation, I am going to work with children. They are going to see a video on YouTube
to explain the better way how the conditional function. And like we are working always with the workbook, we are going to fill the pages 16 and 17. They are working, they are about the topic of the unit. It is the travel and transport. So after this, I am going to work with the students because we are going to match. This is my supplementary activity. How we are going to match about the conditional, and I am going to see how the students understand the topic. Each student have to pass to the front of the whiteboard and match every conditional with the statements. So the first conditional, zero conditional, second and third conditional. The first statement said, if we go on a cruise, we will have a wonderful time. So the correct answer is the first conditional. Like I said, the thing is can be true. So the if have money, I would fly to the moon. This is the second conditional because it can be not true. The next statement said, if I am in a hurry, I take a taxi. This is a zero conditional because it can be true. If I had known you didn't have a ticket, I would have given you one. So this is a third conditional. If I wake up early, I don't miss the bus. Also, this is a zero conditional. If you let now, you might catch the last bus. So this is the second conditional. If you take the train, you'll be there in 4 hours. This is the first conditional. And the last statement said, if I had taken the bus, I wouldn't have had an accident. So this is the third conditional. That's like the students match the paper, and they can win an extra point. After this, the students apply in the book. We have to solve these pages, which are 28 and 27. So finally, we can do the homework. It would be to do the vocabulary, like I said, every class. They must to study on pages number 7 and number 8. Thank you very much.